Hey guys, today we're filming a nursing video. A lot of you guys have been asking us to do nursing videos. Like, we've been getting messages about it, so we thought we'd finally start with some. Today what we're going to be addressing is how to impress your mentor. You have to understand that a lot of the times your mentor has been in your position. She has been a student before, and like with me, even like my mentor, just the one I just, the placement I just finished, my mentor, she graduated like a year or two ago, so she knew like exactly what I was going through.
Some
do understand, but some others,
some forget that they used to be a nurse, like a student nurse. So then, because they've now increased, they've now gone up that hierarchy, they think that, oh, you know, I can just do this to you. But you have to understand that, like, you know, like, she's my mentor, isn't it? Like, she's going to sign my skills, she's going to do everything. So, you know, you just have to attach yourself. Yeah, just beg friends.
Because to be honest, sometimes, like, mentors, they treat a student like a burden.
They do.
I've got a student today, and it's like,
yeah, you can hear them saying that. It's
still, like, someone that they do in front of you, like, oh, you're working with me. You're my mentor. So,
you still have to keep that smile on. You can't let that keep you down, because at the end of the day, you just have to think ahead. This is your degree, okay? This woman, she's gonna finish her shift and go home at the end of the night. She's still got her job. This is your degree, so business is business. You just have to keep a smile and, like, continue with your day.
And you know,
right?
What? Some of them say that in the morning, like, are you really working with me? Like, do you want to work with someone else? But once you start working with them, it's like, oh my god, thank you so much, you've helped me so much.
Because you help them.
And it's like, well, in the morning, you didn't say that, did you?
So, like, the first step of, like impressing your mentor is to be punctual, guys. Be on time. Don't be 5-10 minutes late. Your patient's waiting for you. Always think about the night staff that are coming off their shift that are waiting on you to come as a nurse, okay? Think as a nurse. Don't think, oh, I'm a student, I don't matter in the team. Just consider yourself a staff, because that's what they're considering as, depending on where you're working, but still. Because sometimes they put you on the rota, you're considered a part of the team, so you make sure you're punctual, you're on time. That shows that you want to learn, okay? If you're like 10 to 15 minutes late all the time.
And if you're late, make sure you call them up. You know, it's obviously accidents do happen, like train and buses and all of that. If you are late, call them like 10 minutes before and be like, oh, I'm going to be late today. That would, like, show them that you're serious. Like, you know what I mean? But if you just come in while they're doing handover or something, you just sit down, it's like...
And a lot of time, it's embarrassing, especially when I'm working ITU. You know, in the normal ward where I was used to, like, you'd go around in the handover, like, you'd go from bed to bed to bed. So no one would realize you're coming in, because you're just walking while
this
you're doing
one, they're like in the room.
But because in ITU, they're in a room, it's like a living room. So when you walk in, everyone, bam, looks at you.
Yeah.
It's like, you're late. And the screw that you get, oh my gosh.
I was never late, but when I see other nurses, it's embarrassing.
It's like the screw they get. They literally was like,
yeah.
I'm like, well, damn. Oh, wow. Like, thank God that's not me. Yeah. And that's a qualified nurse, imagine. So it's like, don't be late. Like, seriously, just don't. Like, always, even though it's really hard to wake up early in the morning, it's so hard.
It's so hard, especially 7:30, guys. You have to get there at 7:30. Wake up at 7:30. Get there at 7:30.
Especially when you're doing ITU and you have to change, you have to put on your scrubs. So, like, you have to get there, go get changed, go to the handover room. It's like so long. So make sure you space out your time and make sure, like, you fit all in, okay?
Yeah.
Also, make sure you wear your uniform, your badge, everything you have.
Especially
on
the badge, guys. You think it's so small, like, oh, it's not that deep. That's what happened to me. The badge is the most important, because, like, what you do, how am I supposed to know, like, what is your name? Do you get what I mean? Especially when you just come there, your mentor's like, hey, you look good, but where's your badge? And it's like, oh, like, you think, oh, it's just a badge. But it's not just a badge, because the patient, once they see you, it's embarrassing. Like, oh, what's your name?
The first thing they look for is your badge. Like, even the doctors, they're like, oh,
what's your name? Like,
so always have your badge.
It's actually the hassle as well, to having to repeat your name. Like,
that happened to me in my placement when I was in my first year. There was a time where I didn't have a badge because I lost it.
Yeah.
Stupid me. And I was so, like, dumb, because I didn't know that I could go to university and get another one, like, there straight away. So I was, here's me going through my 6 weeks of placement, 7 weeks of placement with no badge. On my first day, I'm there proper on time, everything. They're like, oh, in front of everyone, handover, oh, where's your badge? I could have thought of something smart. I could have been like, I don't have it on me.
Yeah.
I could have said, I don't know. I could have said, I was like, I lost it. I lost in the middle of handover. I saw all the, like, the other students, they were just like, Hasu, you shouldn't have said that.
Yeah.
She just said like, oh, I don't have it on me right now, or it's in my bag, or something like that.
Yeah.
That was embarrassing. See, always be punctual and proper, okay?
Yeah.
Thank God I wasn't marked down for anything because my mental was nice.
Yeah.
So find out what your trust policy is and follow it, please. And call in. Don't just not show up because that looks really, really bad on you and it's very unprofessional.
Yeah.
So be professional, okay?
Another topic is to be proactive, guys. This is very, 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 very important, guys.
I can't even stress how important
it is. It's so important. Like, even if you don't know what you're doing in the ward,
just do something.
Do something. Like, I'm an active person, so alhamdulillah, that just came with me. So, like, even if I'm not doing anything, like, I'll force myself to do something because I just don't like chilling there. But you get some people that don't do anything in the ward. They'll just stand there and wait for the mentors to come up to them and be like, do you want to help? That doesn't show that I'm a good impression.
And it's really annoying. I don't know if it's just me because I'm a student even myself. And when I see other students just standing there, it just makes me really annoyed because it looks down all the, it makes all the students look bad as well.
Yeah.
Especially if they're from the same university.
It's it's like, just do something. Don't just stand there and wait to be told. Like, just be like,
get the patient notes. Just sit, just read it.
Get the BNF. Get the BNF. Start like finding out medications that you've done today. Find out what they need. Find out what they're for.
Or shadow your mentor.
Yeah, just shadow her. Like, you can get annoyed, but just shadow her.
Just follow her.
It's better than just
be a bug, not doing it. Just be annoying.
Yeah.
To be honest, that's the kind of what they're doing for you. Anyway,
yeah,
so just be annoying.
Do even if she's going to pick up paper, I'll still follow. All right, not to the extreme, but like,
don't
we should do something
don't
like
follow her to the toilet, guys.
No, that's the toilet. I'm still here. Like, no,
don't follow her.
My mental health, like, you know, she said that there was a student here that literally followed her ever, even to the toilet. She was going to the toilet. She's like, what were you doing? She's like, yeah, I'm following. She's like, no, I'm going to the toilet. She's like, oh, okay, she's gonna follow her to the toilet.
Oh, that's nice, that's so cute.
It's so cute, but it's like, so cute. That's what they see, and they're like, oh wow, she's actually proactive. But if you're just standing there, like,
waiting to be told, it makes you lazy, to be honest.
Yeah.
Don't be the lazy student, because to be honest, like, just by walking around and trying to find things to do, even if your mentor is busy, go to other nurses. You know, some nurses that really want to help you, they really want you to learn.
Yeah.
So, like, for me, I remember when my mentor was busy, there was a nurse that in ITU, the patient next to me, I'd go to her, we'd talk, and like, she'd tell, because she's a Spanish nurse, so I'd teach her things like in English, like medical things that she wanted to know. Oh, how do you say, she'd say it in Spanish, and I'll type in Google, and I would translate. Like, that's literally, that's like a basic thing, but at least I'm doing something, you know, I'm not sitting there just like looking at the computer, waiting for something.
Even at times as well, like, my mentor would be like, we'll finish my medications and everything, and I'll see that another nurse is struggling, I'll just be like, oh, nurse, you want me to help you out? Like, obviously she would have to be there when I'm giving, like, doing the medication, but at least I'm still helping her, because while I'm doing one thing, she's doing another, so that time goes quicker. She got me, and it helps her out with her, like, you know, her stuff as well.
Yeah.
And stuff like, you don't, if there's nothing to do, go and chill with the patient. Like, you have some patients that really need you to talk, like,
they want to talk to you.
Yeah, like, I had this one patient, she was amazing. Like, I want to cry right now, because when she left, I was in there. So, like, every single shift, I'll go there and just sit down with her, and she'll give me, like, her story, like, her life. She'll make me laugh. And then there was this day when I came in and
she wasn't there.
I wanted to cry so bad. I was like, where is she? They were like, oh yeah, she's gone home. I was like,
oh, at least she's alive.
Yeah.
But like, for me, and if you're proactive, the nurses tell each other. When I'm in ITU, because in ITU you have a patient, you have one patient. So obviously, when there's me and a nurse, it's like, it can be really boring at times, because just you have that one patient to take care of, right? So what I'll do is, if my nurse is done with whatever we need to do, I go around literally every bed and I'll be like, to the nurse, do you need any help? Do you need any help? And a lot of the times they do. So I'd help them, and then one of the nurses, she was like, oh my god, she has such a lovely student. I'll pass her now. Let her go home. She's very proactive. She doesn't wait for you to ask for help. She comes and asks. Be that student, please, because honestly, it makes your, and like, the nurse, your mentor becomes proud. Like, she's like, oh yeah, that's my student.
Like, even when she's not there, she knows that she can trust you. Like, you know, like, it's just,
and
it's
a nice smile feeling of my mentor's face. Like, I'm just like, I know.
It's such a nice feeling.
I know.
Yeah.
It makes you really proud of yourself, to be honest.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, I heard this. Like, this nurse said this about you. I'm like, girl. Yeah, I know. Like, it's really nice. Like,
it's really nice. Be proactive, please.
It's really,
okay.
Yeah.
Another thing that goes off being proactive is ask a lot of questions.
Mm.
To be honest, ask as many questions as you can, because not only are you like learning for yourself, like, if your mentor doesn't know, like just ask so many questions.
Like,
if she's like turning a patient in a way that you're not used to, say, oh, I've never seen that before, why do you do that way? Like, question everything, like, as if she's Google, like, consider her Google.
I had one mentor that we was giving medication, but she I asked, I was like, oh, what's this medication? And she didn't know herself as well, so she got the BNF. She was like, oh, let's research this together. So it's like, she learned something, I learned something, do you know what I mean? And like Hafsa said, the most simple stuff here, like doing bedding or something, like, when I went to another ward, the way they done the beds was completely different. So when I came to do my bed, they were like, no, don't do like this. I was thinking, oh, why is that? And then they just explained, like, oh, yeah, this is simple. It's like you're learning.
And like from different nurses, you can learn different things. So even if you're going to ask the same question twice, don't like. And if you feel like your question's dumb, honestly, I know this sounds very cliche, but no question's dumb. When you're looking after a patient, all of things can be a big, big difference to them, because they're really sick. You have to consider that. So even if you're unsure about something, just ask. It won't kill to ask. Just ask, you know? So
no question is stupid, but like if you know that you can go research it yourself,
do that.
Go and research it yourself first. And if you completely don't understand it, come back to your mentor. Do you get what I mean? Because like at times, there's some question that you think that, oh, like, I don't understand this. But if you actually sit down and research, you'll be like, oh, so it meant like this, you get what I mean? So, yeah.
Another point of being proactive is, you know, like, once you're in the ward for like a week, you get the gist of the routine of the ward. You get the gist of, you know, get the balls ready, get everything ready, get the patient ready, give them a bath or a shower or whatever they want, get them changed, get the bedding done clean. Like, you know the morning routine. So just don't wait for someone to be like, oh, let's go and do this.
Yeah.
You, like, you know the patients that you can take on by yourself. Mm-hmm. So if you have, if there's a patient that you can just walk to the shower and give them a shower, do it. Don't wait for someone to say, oh, can you do that patient while I do this one? Or like, if you see a patient that really needs to be changed, go to the HCA and be like, can you help me change this patient? Because don't consider yourself lower than the nurses and think, oh, you know, all the HCAs and think, oh no, I have to wait for them. Like, be like, confident in yourself and think, oh yeah, I can do this, let's do it together, you know? So that's one of the things of being practical. Have a list of things that you can do in the morning. You know, now ITU placement, I know people talk about ITU, but this is where I just came from, so it's fresh in my mind. In ITU, there was a routine where every morning you'd have your patient and you have to do the checks, the emergency checks, check if the ventilator's working, if they have all the emergency oxygen and everything, all the emergency equipment there. That was so everyone, before, when I came in, I didn't have to like sit with the nurse and just wait for her to tell me to do something. I'd go around, do the checks, clean around, you know, all the basic things. And then when they saw, they're like, oh wow, you've done this before. And I was like, yeah. You see? So it shows that you're proactive that way, you know?
Yeah. Like, there was a time where, like, we was like, there was only like three staffs in the ward, and literally there was one HCA, guys, one HCA.
But so the HCA is a healthcare assistant, yeah?
So, like, someone that just helps
support, like, what she helps,
all of that. There was one HCA, right? So I was thinking, because obviously I'm used to washes and everything, so why could my mentor, she had to do CD, so that's controlled drugs, so like, check like for controlled drugs and everything. So when I saw that, I was like, okay, there's only one HCA and there's like two patients that are like independent, why don't I just help them? Literally, I just went in there, got them to the shower, washed them by myself. Literally, I done everything. Four patients, I washed them by myself. She came back, she was like, okay, let's do the wash. I was like, okay, I already done four of them. She was like, four by yourself? Ha. I was like, yeah, because you was busy, so I'm not gonna wait around and wait. Do you know what I mean? Because at the end of the day, me and her are gonna do this. Why not? Why can't I just do it by myself? Do you know what I mean? So yeah, that's exactly basically it.
And then that way she'll know, oh wow, Zoe's really independent. She doesn't have to think, oh, is she able to do this? Like, that shows independence as well.
Our fourth point is to show interest, guys. By that I mean there'll be so many stuff, like, for example, you spoke about, oh, be proactive and everything, right? Show interest, like, ask your mentor that you want to go and do something else. Like, if you're working, because I worked in an oncology ward, I worked in a rehab ward, especially a rehab, there's so many stuff I've done. So when my mentor finished giving medication, and if I'm like, oh, can I go and talk to the OTs, that's occupational therapist. So she was like, yeah, go, like, shadow them for a bit.
The PTs as well.
Yeah, go to the PTs as well. Just shadow them. So it's like, you're showing, like, once they see that, it's like, oh wow, she really wants to learn. Do you know what I mean? Don't just be like, because I'm a student nurse, that's what, that's my role. I'm just going to shadow my mentor, just sit there. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Do other stuff that.
And also, you know, a lot of the times the nurses will go out of their way and they'll go to explain something to you. Please don't look bored, because a lot of, like, there's a lot of students that just stand there and just, like, look.
Yeah.
And it's like, I look like you want to learn, like, show that you're interested. Don't look like you just don't want to do it.
Yeah.
Like, don't just be there, like, just to have your hours signed. Yeah. Show that you're actually interested in this, because this student is going to be a career for the rest of your life.
Yeah.
So you might as well be interested in it if you really want to do it.
Yeah.
And also, like, if you have, you know, your patients on the ward, if they're going for an MRI scan, CT scan, or an X-ray, be like, can I go?
Yeah.
Like, I had a patient in my gastro ward, he was going for, what was it called? An endoscopy. And I was like, oh, can I go? Mm. Even though the surgeon was a bit rude, I still went in there. I got the chance to see, like, the whole thing and everything. It was really nice. So just asking if you can go follow them to your patient to procedure. Not only are you making your patients comfortable because they're used to you, but also like it shows that you're interested, right? You're not just there just because you're there. Alright?
Yeah. Like luckily I had like my hospital, like all my mentors, alhamdulillah, they were all like everything that's if something was going on, they'd be like, Zaria, go down. Like literally they'll like follow. So like I was kind of used to it, you got me, but you get some mentors that don't ask you to follow. They want you to do, they want to see if you're going to be like, oh, can I, you know, observe, can I do, even like if the doctors are just there, just go in there and be like, oh, I just want to see what's happening, do you got me? Don't just sit in the desk, like in the reception, and just like do nothing, do you got me? Like if there's something big happening, why are you not there, do you got me, when you're a student nurse, exactly, do you got me?
Yeah.
You put yourself into that.
Yeah.
And then not only would that make a mentor proud, that will make other like, you know, professionals like the doctors, the doctors, they will see that you're still a student, do you got me?
I remember in ITU we had a patient, they were inserting a tracheostomy, a trachea tube, and that was so interesting. I was like, wow, how are they going to do that? But then I remember my mentor was like, oh, you need to go for your break now. And I was like, no, but I really want to see this.
Yeah.
And she's like, no, you have to go for your break, because if you don't, then the cycle's going to, and everything. And the doctors actually waited for me to come back from my break so they can do it, because they knew how much I wanted to see it. So when I came back, I was so shocked. I was like, you still haven't done it? They're like, no, we waited for you. And I was like, so like, oh wow, you waited for me. But then like, I actually got to see them doing inserting a tracheostomy, and then after that, I got to see them do a CVP line. It was like so interesting. Like, the amount of things you can like learn by just showing interest that you want to.
Yeah.
Like they would actually stop their time to teach you. So
yeah, and even if like they won't stop their time for you, like literally there'll be a time where it's time for you to go home, but you see something that's so interesting. I just stayed behind. Like my mentor will come back from like something. She'll be like, "You still here?" And I'm like, "Yeah," because I was just watching that. Do you got me? They'll be like, "Okay," but you can go home now. Do you get me?
Another one is like getting to know your patients. I think if your mentor sees that, you know, you're actually interested in the patients and not just interested in the task, and you're actually interested in the person, they're just gonna think, oh wow, like this is actually something she wants to do, like she really likes, she enjoys it, you know. Sit down with your patient, ask them why they're here, how they're feeling, because you have to remember that a hospital for us we can get used to it sometimes because we've been there for a while, but for them it's like a first time experience, and it's never comfortable for them. So like just talk to them. Maybe some of them don't have relatives, so like talking to your patient can also like impress your mentor in some sense, and it's also good for you.
One thing that's really important about getting to know your patient is that there'll be times where your mentor should be really busy, right? So then like you'll be at that, like the reception or something, like the doctor will come through or something, like, okay, are you looking after John, do you know what I mean? And I'll be like, yeah, I'm looking after John, like, you know. And then he'll be like, okay, so what's his condition right now? I'm not good, there's no time for me to go and get my mentor. Do you want to explain to the doctor? If like, because I know my patient, I'll be like, oh yeah, so he was eating and drinking today, he was doing this, he opened his bowels, he's done this, like he went to x-ray today, blah blah blah, record it down. What medication is he on? Say, get his drug chart, tell him, like, do you know what I mean? All of this is like, it saves a lot of time than you getting your mentor to like explain everything when you're the student nurse, you know, you're gonna become that nurse, so why can't you just act like that nurse, do you get what I mean? So then yeah, that shows like a lot of, you know, interest as well. So that's very important. Get to know your patient, very very important.
Definitely, and especially if there's an emergency as well.
Yeah,
you can't be like, oh, what medication are they on, or what is this, what's
you
that
just know.
Like you have to know, so just know your patients for that day. And especially if you get like a moment out, read their notes, like find out why they're in, if they have any background, if they have any like background or any other like previous medical histories, and just search into it honestly, and like see what medications they're on, what the medications are for. There's a lot of things you can do to get to know your patient, and obviously that will in some sense also impress your mentor.
Yeah. Another way you can impress your mentor is bonding with your mentor. So in that sense, what I mean is that just try and get to know your mentor, do you know what I mean? Obviously it's professional and all of that, but if you're on her, like you guys are alone, do you know what I mean? Like be like, oh hi, like how was your day today, do you know what I mean? Oh yeah, my day was this, so what do you like this, or what do you like do? Like just get to know, because then that will open up that space and like a bit of trust, do you know what I mean? That she can tell you. Some mentors are really hard to impress, like they're really hard to break.
Yeah, really hard.
So if she finds out that you're like that open girl, like, you know, you're always bubbly, always like laughing and everything, she's more happy to talk to you, do you know what I mean? Like once you bond with your mentor, you learn so much stuff, because they won't find it hard to talk to you, like they'll be comfortable with you. So yeah, that's it. There's some mentors that will be really hard to like try and bond to, but try your best. Some of them, they know you're trying, so they have in the back of, this student's a very good student, she really wants to like, you know, bond with me and everything. Once your pad document is ready to sign, she can even write it down, and you'll be like, raw, like you notice that. Like, yeah, I did. Like, some of them don't say it, but they do notice it. Do you know what I mean? So it's good, like, for you to just try and bond with your mentor.
Yeah, and they'll be really grateful the shifts they have with you. They'll be like, oh, yeah, I've got half sore today, I've got sore, or she's gonna help me today through the day. It makes their day easy as well. And also, having a book with you all the time is really good as well. Like, in some sense, like, if you have a book and like, and you have questions, you can just write down in the book, you can ask your mentor. That can be a bonding, or it can also be like a question answer time. Please, like, take advantage of your mentors, because sometimes they're not in all the time, are they? They're not in every shift you're working. So when they're in, just like, take that time to bond with them and ask them questions. And one thing I want to say is, a lot of, like, for me, like, before when I was on, when I was in my first year, I was really scared of being asked questions. When I was, like, put on the spot and asked, oh, what is that medication for? What is this for? I used to get really scared. I used to get, like, oh, my gosh, oh, my gosh. But, like, now, my second year, I really like it when people ask me questions, because I feel like I learned that way. Like, I'm not afraid to say, oh, I don't know. Because, I don't know if it was because I was on ITU, but a lot of the nurses, they were really hard. Like, not hard as in the sense of, like, rude, but they were really hard as in, I would, like, randomly, a nurse would stop me that I've never worked with, and he'll be like, oh, what is magnesium for? Oh, why are we checking the magnesium level? Why are we checking the potassium level? Why do we have to do that? Like, I remember one nurse asked me, I think he was a Spanish nurse, and he was like, oh, how does a human breathe? And I was like, what? And I was like, and he's like, how does a human breathe? And then I was like, the inhale, exhale. Like, that's everything came to mind. And he's like, no, that's ventilating. That's not inhaling. That's not breathing. And I was like, whoa. And he's like, go do research. And in a way, it's like, it's whoa. Yeah, but in a way, it's like, good. I'm learning. It's like, whoa. When I actually research it, it's like, oh, breathing actually happens in the cells. It's like, whoa. Like, it's completely different to, like, that's, I don't know, for me personally, that's the way I learn. Some people can find it intimidating, but me personally.
Me and I was like, yeah, and then she's like, good. Like, there was a time when I came into the ward, and I said anti-sickness, and my mentor was like, it's not anti-sickness, it's anti-emetic. So I was like, okay, cool. So there was a time she was like, what's this? And I was like, it's anti-emetic. So there was a time when she was doing medication, right? And she was like, okay, so this is an anti-sickness drug. And I was like, it's not anti-sickness, it's anti-emetic. And then she stopped. And she was like, a student is that teaching me? Okay, and I was like, I'm sorry, I was like, anti-sickness, sorry, real quick.
I got too confident.
And it's like, that's that. Like, it's probably good, isn't it? Because it shows that, like, you've learned something, went there and actually done something. Do you get what I mean?
So don't get scared when they ask you questions. Because a lot of the time, if you don't ask questions, they will ask you. Because they assume you know. It's like, oh, you're not asking. Okay, you know then.
Yeah,
so you learn a lot from questions. Don't get offended and, like, start, like, shaking up if you ask questions. Just learn from them. If you don't know it, go research it. A lot of times they'll tell you, or they will tell you there and then. I had a nurse that told me the whole respiratory system, like, explained in depth in like 15 minutes while we had a patient. So some are really like that, and others are trying
to
research.
Some just assume that you just know it like that. Literally, like,
wow, the Spanish nurses are so good. Like, they, I feel like they're taught, like, really in depth. I'm like, whoa.
And the African ladies, they're really good.
Yeah. And the last point is
to say thank you. Just say thank you.
Everything you appreciative.
Just say thank you. Like, thank you so much that you taught me this. Thank you. They'll just they'll make them happy. Like,
it's like, she said, they're actually impacting your life. Because you have to understand that they're taking time out of their day to teach you. Like, they, all their actual job is to take care of the patients and make sure the patient's safe and everything. Like,
and obviously to teach you as well, but it depends.
So they go, some of them go out of their way to teach you, and it's like, if they do that, like, don't just be ungrateful and be like, okay.
Like, some of them on the, before they break, they're like, come on, let me show you this. Because, I mean, so imagine you don't say thank you, it's like, scheme, like, you got me, but always say thank you. Be like, it just shows them that you really, you're appreciative. Do you get what I mean?
Just
everything, you can get annoying, but just
and,
say thank
and,
you.
And in the place, I feel like this became a ritual for me as a real. We buy our mentors, like, presents,
for no
and, like, you don't have to, like, buy, like, a big, like,
just
present.
Something that
it can be like a Ferrero Rocher or like a chocolate bar or something, but that shows how appreciative you are.
A card is very important because
they'll keep it.
Yeah, always get a card because they'll always keep it. But if the chocolate, they'll eat it and then digest it, and it's like, what's next? They'll put a card. No, they'll always keep it. So, that's basically
it, guys. Yeah, that's our last point. I hope this is really helpful for you guys. For students that are in the first year, or for students that are going to apply,
Good luck.
That's what I can say. Good luck. And let us know if you want anything to do with, like, any other questions with mentors and stuff like that. Okay?
Just list it below and we'll get back to you guys.
Yep.
So on that note, we'll see you in our next video. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. This is what I have to deal with, guys.
Bye.
Peace.
Peace.